Empty that purse.
God forsaken, don't leave me!
Give me all your coin, you know how to... Empty that purse.
God forsaken, don't!
Give me all your coin, you know how to...
I say!
Empty that purse.
God forsaken dog!
Piss off! You wanna catch a beating? Get close! Keep moving, mate.
If I were you, I'd keep that great oar for the brother of yours handy on the night. He gave the throat.
You won't catch him! Leave off!
Better get a shot anyway. Not most definitely.
To business.
What do you need, my friend?
You want to catch a beating? Get closer.
Keep moving, mate.
Are they not appetizing? No fresh attachments here. Just look.
That's our pigs because we could not pay them.
From the guard.
You won't catch it.
Go. It's just another day for me.
Give me all your coin, you know how this works.
Piss off! You wanna catch a beating, get close.
Keep moving, mate.
You won't catch it!
Somebody won't be troubling me any longer. Thank you, mister. Just kinda getting used to being up there. Are you trusting enough?
Tell you.
must inform the local garrison immediately.
Ah, Connor! Your work procedure. Now it's time to finish the job. I'm told this chap just materialized from the ether and nobody has the stones to, you know, challenge him. Until now, we'll need a gang of our own, fight fire with fire.
About time we did something about those brutes. I want in.
Good on you. That's one for the lads. Come on, let's gather the rest.
Boss, close! Get out!
Knights Templar? Jesus. I thought they were a spook story.
They are very real.
I'll take your word for it, lad. Well, it's been a real pleasure. If ever you need a hand in whatever it is you're up to, I'm your man.
Water.
You?
Oh, I can't complain. There was something I've been meaning to tell you. I met your dad. It was a long time ago, in London. I was just a boy. Well, didn't meet him, really. Just saw him do a fella in at the London Opera House. I was sitting in the balcony with an uncle of mine. Went to have a piss. And when I came back, there's your dad. Dashing as they come, he was. Shirt, jacket, immaculate. My uncle. Was just slumped there. Looked like he was sleeping, but I knew better, even if I was only a child. Your da locked eyes on me. And I don't think I've ever been so frightened as I was in that instant. It wasn't a fear that he was going to cause me pain. It was this sense that he saw right through me, into my heart, and he would crush it if it had pleased him. But he didn't. He just raised his finger to his lips and gestured for my silence. I complied, and then he was gone.
That must have been in the days before his betrayal was made public. He would have sailed for the colonies not long after. I'm astonished that you were actually there.
You can imagine my surprise when I saw his face. Took me a while to piece it together, but there you have it. Thought you'd like to know.
Thank you. How are you faring?
I'm not bad, not bad. All this reminds me of being back in the old country. Fighting for land, fighting for the right to see God my way. Didn't take long before I realized the fight was futile, except aboard a ship bound for the colonies. People over there are so wrapped up in how you perceive the Lord, they forget we're all part of his flock. Stories change, Connor. The way people tell them evolves. It's no different in the Bible, and I believe that's the real root of all the strife back home. Nobody wants to listen to me. If you don't see it their way, you're a heathen. But I feel we're honestly making a difference here. That our presence is felt, if not appreciated by all. And it makes me sleep easy at night, and that's all a man can ask for, really.
I would like to visit your home country someday.
How would you know? You'd turn a head or two in the Emerald Isle, I'll tell you that. Maybe one day I'll muster up the courage, go back, I'll bring you with me. It'll be good for a laugh at any rate.